This question says, express 140 as the product of its prime factors. Let's begin with the solution and factorize 140 with the help of the factor tree. Now 140 can be expressed as 2 into 70. Now 2 is a prime number and 70 is a composite number. Therefore 70 can further be written as 2 into 35. Here again 2 is a prime number. And 35 can be expressed as 5 into 7. Now here both 5 and 7 are prime numbers. Therefore the factorization stops here. And thus 140 can be written as 2 into 2 into 5 into 7. This is equal to 2 square into 5 into 7. Hence our answer is 140 can be expressed as 2 square into 5 into 7, which is the product of its prime factors. So this completes the solution. This question says, express 156 as the product of prime factors. Let's begin with the solution and we will factorize 156 with the help of factor tree. Now 156 can be written as 2 into 78. Now 2 is a prime factor, therefore it cannot be factorized further. And 78 can be written as the product of 2 into 39. Again 2 is a prime factor, therefore 39 can be written as 3 into 13. Now as we can see, 3 and 13 both are prime factors. Therefore 156 can be written as 2 into 2 into 3 into 13, or 2 square into 3 into 13. Hence 156 can be expressed as 2 square into 3 into 13 as the product of prime factors. This completes the solution. In this question, we have to express 3825 as the product of its prime factors. Let's begin with the solution and we have to write down 3825 as the product of its primes. Now this can be written as 3 multiplied by 1275. Since on multiplying 3 with 1275 we get 3825. Now 3 is a prime factor. Therefore factorizing 1275 further, we have 3 multiplied by 425. Now again 3 is a prime factor. And so factorizing 425 further, we have, this can be written as 5 multiplied by 85. Now here again 5 is a prime factor, therefore factorizing 85 further, we have 5 multiplied by 17. Now here both 5 and 17 are prime factors, therefore the prime factorization of 3825 ends here, and 3825 can be written as 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 17. That is 3 square multiplied by 5 square multiplied by 17. Hence, on expressing the given number 3825 as the product of its prime factors, we have 3 square multiplied by 5 square multiplied by 17. This completes the solution. This question says, express 5005 as the product of its prime factors. Beginning with the solution, Let us factorize 5005 with the help of the factor 3. Now the smallest factor which divides 5005 is 5. Therefore it can be expressed as 5 into 1001. Now 5 is a prime factor and 1001 being a composite number can be expressed as 7 into 143. Now here 7 is again a prime factor. And 143 being a composite number can be expressed as 11 into 13. Now here both 11 and 13 are prime factors. Therefore the factorization stops here. And 5005 can be written as 5 into 7 into 11 into 13. This completes the solution. This question says, express 7429 as the product of its prime factors. Now, let us factorize 7429 with the help of the factor tree. Now, the smallest factor which divides 7429 is 17 and the quotient is 437. Now, here 17 is a prime factor, therefore it cannot be factorized further. 437 can be written as 19 into 23. Now here both 19 and 23 are prime factors. Hence the factorization stops here and 7429 can be expressed as 17 into 19 into 23. This completes the solution. This question says, find the LCM and HCF of the following pair of integers and the numbers are 26 and 91 and then we have to verify that LCM into HCF is equal to the product of two numbers. Let's begin with the solution and the given numbers are 26 and 91. Now first let us factorize 26 with the help of factor tree. It can be written as 2 into 13 and both 2 and 13 are prime factors, therefore 26 is equal to 2 into 13. Now let us factorize 91. 91 can be written as 7 into 13. 7 is the smallest factor which divides 91 and therefore 91 is equal to 7 into 13 and both 7 and 13 are prime factors, therefore they cannot be factorized further and 91 can be written as 7 into 13. The highest common factor of 26 and 91, as we can see the factors of 26 are 2 and 13 and the factors of 91 are 7 and 13. The highest common factor is 13. So HCF is 13 and LCM is 2 into 7 into 13 and this is equal to 182. Now let us verify that LCM into HCF is equal to the product of two numbers. First, let us find the LCM and the product of HCF. This is equal to 13 into 182, which gives 2366. And the product of two numbers, which is 26 and 91, is equal to 2366. Hence, we have LCM into HCF is equal to product of the two numbers, which are 26 and 91. So this completes the solution. In this question, we have to first find the LCM and HCF of 510 and 92, and then we have to verify that the product of LCM and HCF is equal to the product of the two numbers. Let's begin with the solution. And the two numbers are 510 and 92. First, let us find the factors of 510. Now, 2 divides 510 and 2 multiplied by 255 gives 510. Now, 2 is a prime number. Therefore, we will find the factors of 255. Now, the smallest prime number which divides 255 is 3. And 3 multiplied by 85 is equal to 255. Here again, 3 is a prime factor. Therefore, we will find the factors of 85 now. 85 can be written as 5 multiplied by 17. And here both 5 and 17 are prime numbers. Therefore, 510 can be written as 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 17. Now let us find the factors of the second number, which is 92. The smallest number which divides 92 is 2, and 2 multiplied by 46 gives 92. Now here 2 is a prime number, therefore we will find the factors of 46 now. 46 can be written as 2 multiplied by 23, and now 2 and 23 both are prime numbers, therefore 92 can be written as 2 square multiplied by 23. Now let us first find the LCM. We know that LCM is the product of the greatest power of each prime factor involved in these two numbers. Therefore, it is equal to 2, and the greatest power of 2 is 2 multiplied by 3. 3 has power 1. Multiplied by 5, its greatest power is also 1, multiplied by 17, multiplied by 23. And this is equal to 23,460. Now let us find the HCF. And HCF is the product of the smallest power of each common factor in the numbers. And here the common factor is 2. And its smaller power is 1. Therefore, we have HCF is equal to 2 raised to the power 1. So, this is equal to 2. Now, let us find the product of LCM and HCF. This is equal to 23,460 multiplied by 2, which is equal to 46,920. Now let us find the product of the two given numbers. That is product of 510 and 92. So this is equal to 510 multiplied by 92. And on multiplying 510 with 92, we get 46,920. Hence we have LCM multiplied by HCF is equal to the product of 510 and 92. This completes the solution. This question says, find the LCM and HCF of the following pair of integers, and the integers are 336 and 54. And then we have to verify that the product of LCM and HCF is equal to the product of the two numbers. Let's begin with the solution. And the given numbers are 336 and 54. First, let us factorize 336 with the help of factor tree. Now the smallest factor which divides 336 is 2. So 2 into 168 gives 336. Now 2 is a prime factor, therefore it cannot be factorized further. 168 being a composite number can be written as 2 into 84. Now here again 2 is a prime factor, therefore 84 can be written as 2 into 42. Now 2 is a prime factor, therefore 42 can be written as 2 into 21. And again 2 is a prime factor, therefore 21 can be written as 3 into 7. Now 3 and 7 both are prime factors, therefore it cannot be factorized further, and hence 336 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 7, that is 2 raised to the power 4 into 3 into 7. Now let us factorize 54. 54 can be written as 2 into 27. 2 being a prime factor cannot be factorized further, and 27 can be written as 3 nines are 27. Again, 3 being a prime factor cannot be factorized, and 9 can be written as 3 into 3. Now both 3 are prime factors, therefore 54 can be written as 2 into 3 into 3 into 3, or 2 into 3 raised to the power 3. Hence, HCF of 336 and 54, that is the highest common factor, is 2 into 3, which is equal to 6, and LCM of 336 and 54 is 2 raised to the power 4 into 3 cube into 7, and this is equal to 3024. Now let us find the product of HCF and LCM. This is equal to 6 into 3024, which is equal to 18,144. Now let us find the product of the two numbers 336 and 54. This is equal to 18,144. This implies that the product of HCF and LCM is equal to the product of 336 and 54. Hence, HCF into LCM is equal to the product of two numbers. So this completes the solution. This question says, find the LCM and HCF of the following integers by applying the prime factorization method. Beginning with the solution, the given numbers are 12, 15 and 21. Let us first factorize 12. 12 can be written as 2 into 6. Now 2 is a prime number, therefore it cannot be factorized further. 6 can be written as 2 into 3. Now 2 and 3 both are prime factors, therefore 12 can be written as 2 into 2 into 3. Next, let us factorize 15. Now the smallest factor which divides 15 is 3, and 3 into 5 is 15. And since 3 and 5 both are prime factors, therefore it cannot be factorized further. Therefore 15 is equal to 3 into 5. Now let us factorize 21. 21 is 3 into 7. And since 3 and 7 both are prime factors, therefore
21 can be written as 3 into 7.
Now first let us find the HCF of 12, 15 and 21. Now the common factor among 12, 15 and 21 is 3. Therefore HCF of 12, 15 and 21 is 3. And LCM of 12, 15 and 21 is equal to 2 square into 3 into 5 into 7, and this is equal to 420. Hence our answer is HCF of the given numbers is equal to 3 and LCM of the given numbers is equal to 420. So this completes the solution. This question says, find the LCM and HCF of the following integers, and the integers are 17, 23 and 29 by applying the prime factorization method. Let's begin with the solution, and the numbers given to us are 17, 23 and 29. Notice that 17, 23 and 29 are prime numbers since they have only two factors, the number itself and the number 1. Now let us find the LCM of these number, which is equal to 17 into 23 into 29, and this is equal to 11,339, and HCF is, the highest common factor is 1. Therefore HCF is equal to 1. This completes the solution. This question says, find the LCM and HCF of the following integers by applying the prime factorization method, and the numbers are 8, 9 and 25. Now the given numbers are 8, 9 and 25. Now 8 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2, that is 2 cube. 9 can be written as 3 into 3, that is 3 square, and 25 can be written as 5 into 5, and this is equal to 5 square. Now the LCM of 8, 9 and 25 is equal to the product of the smallest power of each common prime factor in the numbers, that is 2 cube into 3 square into 5 square, and this is equal to 1800. And HCF of 8, 9 and 25 is the product of the smallest power of each common prime factor in the numbers, and the common prime factor in the number is 1. Therefore HCF is equal to 1. Hence our answer is LCM of the given numbers is 1800 and HCF of the given numbers is equal to 1. So this completes the solution. In this question we are given HCF of two numbers 306 and 657 is equal to 9, and we have to find the LCM of these two numbers. Let's begin with the solution, and here we are given that HCF of 306 and 657 is equal to 9, and we know that for any two positive integers A and B, we have HCF of A and B multiplied by LCM of A and B is equal to the product of A and B. So this implies that HCF of 306 and 657 into LCM of 306 and 657 is equal to the product of the two numbers, and the two numbers are 306 and 657. Therefore, we have 306 into 657. Now, we are given that HCF of 306 and 657 is equal to 9. Therefore, substituting the value of HCF, we have 9 into LCM of 306 and 657 is equal to 306 multiplied by 657. This further implies that LCM of 306 and 657 is equal to 306 multiplied by 657 divided by 9. Now, 9 threes are 27, 9 fours are 36. Therefore, we have 34 into 657, which is equal to 22,338. Hence, our answer is LCM of the two given numbers, 306 and 657, is equal to 22,338. This completes the solution. This question says, check whether 6 raised to the power n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number n. Let's begin with the solution and let, if possible, 6 raised to the power n for any natural number n ends with 0. Then this implies that it is divisible by the prime factor 5. Now 6 raised to the power n can be written as 2 into 3 raised to the power n. That is 2 raised to the power n into 3 raised to the power n. Thus, the number 6 raised to the power n has prime factors which are the powers of 2 and 3. That is, 6 raised to the power n has no prime factor 5, and hence it cannot end with the digit 0. And hence our assumption in the beginning that 6 raised to the power n ends with a 0 is wrong. Hence, our answer is 6 raised to the power n cannot end with the digit 0. So this completes the solution. In this question, we have to explain why the given two numbers are composite numbers. Let's begin with the solution. And the first one is 7 multiplied by 11 multiplied by 13 plus 13. Now here, we have two terms, 7 multiplied by 11 multiplied by 13 and 13. In these two terms, we see that 13 is common to both the terms. Therefore, this can further be written as 13 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 11 multiplied by 1 plus 1. This is further equal to 13, and in the bracket we have 77 plus 1, and this is equal to 13 multiplied by 78. Now this is further equal to 13 multiplied by 78 is a composite number. Therefore, let us find its prime factors. 78 can be written as 2 multiplied by 39, and 39 can further be written as 3 multiplied by 13. Therefore, 78 can be written as 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 13. This is further equal to 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 13 square. Now, the given number can be expressed as the product of primes. Therefore, the given number 7 multiplied by 11 multiplied by 13 plus 13 is a composite number. That is, since 7 multiplied by 11 multiplied by 13 plus 13 can be expressed as the product of primes, therefore, it is a composite number. Now, the second number is 7 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1 plus 5. Now, here again, in these two terms, 5 is the common factor. Therefore, taking 5 common from both the terms, we have inside the bracket 7 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1 plus 1. On multiplying, 7 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1, we get 1008, and we have plus 1, so this is equal to 5 multiplied by 1009. Now here, 5 and 1009 both are prime numbers. And since 7 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1 plus 5 can be expressed as the product of primes, therefore it is a composite number. Hence, the two given numbers can be expressed as the product of primes. Therefore, the two given numbers are composite numbers. This completes the solution. This question says, there is a circular path around a sports field. Sonia takes 18 minutes to drive one round of the field, while Ravi takes 12 minutes for the same. Suppose they both start at the same point and at the same time and go in the same direction. After how many minutes will they meet again at the starting point? Let's begin with the solution. And suppose this is the circular path around the sports field along which Sonia and Ravi are driving. Suppose from this point, they start at the same time and they move in the same direction. Then, we have to find after how many minutes are they going to meet again at the starting point. Now, Sonia takes one round in 18 minutes and Ravi takes the same round in 12 minutes. Now, by taking LCM of the time taken by Sonia and the time taken by Ravi, we can get the actual minutes when they again meet at the starting point after they start from the same point and at the same time, and also when they go in the same direction. Now, 18 can be written as 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3, that is 2 multiplied by 3 square, and 12 can be written as 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3, that is 2 square into 3. Now, we know that LCM is the product of the greatest power of each prime factor involved in the numbers. Therefore, LCM of 18 and 12 is equal to 2 raised to the greatest power of 2 is 2 into 3 raised to the power 2. This is equal to 4 into 9, which is equal to 36. Hence, after 36 minutes, both Sonia and Ravi will meet again at the starting point. So this completes the solution.